Hello everybody, this is an instructional video entitled Chase Frazier's RPR Proves Writing Short. Yes, Chase Frazier, the second son of Tammy Frazier, has just passed the RPR. And like his older brother, he writes super short. He learned my theory and he worked hard to shorten his writing in addition to my theory, and he's just doing fantastic. Well, we found out, of course, that he just passed the RPR, and he told me that he passed with 76 strokes per 100 words. Now that's really short. That's about the same as what Melody did when she passed her first 200. She had 75 strokes per 100 words. So that number means something, or it will show us something that's pretty amazing, that I say really proves that writing short is important. Let me show it to you. Okay, this is my speed calculator that I've shown you before, and right now it's set at numbers that match the speed contest results of the average speed contestant from the 70s and 80s. The average top four placer contestant, which is really excellent writer. That they went 5.1 strokes per second and 110 strokes per 100 words on average. That got them about 280 in the Q&A. So, Chase reported that he wrote 76 strokes for every 100 words. So we put 76. That means that if Chase can get his fingers, folks, up to the same finger speed as the speed champions of the 70s and 80s, who got 280, Chase, with his performance, could write 400 words per minute. You hear that, Chase? I say go for it. I want you to become the new world record holder. You just got to get your fingers as fast as regular speed contest people, the top four placers, 5.1 strokes per second. But what Chase did do is he passed 225. So how fast were his fingers? I think I calculated that it's about 2.85 strokes per second is how fast he wrote. It rounds to 2.9, and look, that produces a 225. So in case you want to know what kind of finger speed is 2.9, basically 3 strokes a second is a fairly fast student, but it's not even court reporter speed, folks. So Chase passed the RPR with his fingers moving considerably slower than court reporter speed. In fact, 3.5 strokes a second is typical court reporter speed, comfortable court reporter speed, and 4 strokes a second is fast court reporter. So let's move over and take a look at the rest of my speed calculator. It allows you to change some other blue numbers here, and if you change these other blue numbers, you can get some other results. So my question is, if Chase wrote 2.9 with 76 and got 225, how fast of a finger speed would a court reporter have to write if the average court reporter is taking the RPR and gets 115 strokes per 100 words? That seems to be the average. So I go over here, click there, and change this one to 115. Boom! That's the figure we want right here. And that says that the average court reporter would have to write 4.3 strokes per second just to pass the RPR, folks. No wonder the RPR is hard for our average court reporter. 4.3 is a fast court reporter, and it's approaching speed contest literary. In fact, that is the average speed contest literary speed for top four placers in the 70s and 80s. So all this write it out stuff has caused regular court reporters to have to write really fast to pass the RPR. But Chase wrote very slow and passed the RPR. His fingers moved less than 3 strokes per second. This, I believe, proves once again in another way how writing short is far superior to writing out. And Chase, since you managed to get 0.76 without even leaving any Q&As out, start training, buddy. I think you can do a world record, 400 words a minute. I challenge you to go for it. You can do it, buddy. All right, I hope the rest of you will be inspired by Chase to shorten your writing. It allows you to pass difficult tests with low finger speed. Have a great day, and try out the Magnum Steno Club. Bye-bye.